Now that we've got the board turned on, let's figure out how to connect our laptop to it. So remember earlier I said there were two cables in that box. One is a USB cable and one is an HDMI cable. Both of these cables are very important to use. One is for audio and video and one is for touch. Most of you should be familiar with an HDMI cable. These are the kinds of cables that we use on our TVs at home and we connect our cable boxes. This is the audio and video cable. So where this goes is actually on the side of our board. If you look on the side of the board, you're gonna see three HDMI ports. Best practice is that this goes into HDMI 1. Now it already might be plugged into your board, so just take a look. Obviously, if it's not, we wanna plug it in. So I'm gonna go ahead and plug this into HDMI 1, and we can just let it hang there. Next is our USB cable. Again, you should be familiar with the USB cable. Now, a USB cable has two different sides on it. One looks like a rectangle and one is more square with a bump on it. This is for touch. So the rectangle one will go into our laptop. The more square one with the bump, that's gonna go into the side of the panel over by the the HDMI cable. So what we're gonna wanna do is find where it says touch one. Now this part is a little confusing, but we need to make sure that it's plugged into touch one because it's colored blue. And HDMI 1 is also colored blue. So it doesn't matter which number you're plugged in, it just has to match colors, so blue to blue. You'll also see that there's a touch 2, which is yellow or orange. We don't wanna use that one. Again, we wanna be on touch 1. This is common sometimes if you don't have touch for those cables to accidentally be switched. So again, HDMI 1 and touch 1. So now that we have both of our cables plugged into the board, what we're gonna wanna do is connect them to our laptop. Now your laptop might be different than mine, that's okay, but we should have an HDMI port on our laptop as well as a USB port. You might be doing it through some sort of display adapter. Some laptops have these built directly in. So we'll go ahead and plug these both in, USB and HDMI. Now you'll notice here that the board automatically switches to my laptop as soon as it detects a video signal. So I didn't actually have to switch from the embedded player in order to get to this. So if you remember from earlier, if we touch the home button, that takes us to this screen here, okay? This is the embedded OS. We actually don't wanna use the embedded OS. We really wanna be using our connected laptop. And so the way that I switch, if you ever get to this screen, right, I'm showing you this kind of as a non-example, like I don't want you to go here, is there's a couple ways. One, you'll notice down here, it says HDMI 1. Remember, that's what I just plugged into the board was HDMI 1. So that's what I touch in order to switch back. So if I touch that HDMI 1, it's going to switch back to my laptop from the embedded OS. The second way we can do this is that if I touch the settings button, so the settings button is that cogwheel button, if I touch that, it's going to open up my input menu. And again, you'll see there is HDMI 1. The difference here is that you actually touch it once to get a little preview, so it'll show a preview window of your laptop, and then touch it again, that'll actually switch. So there's two ways to switch from the embedded OS to your connected laptop. One is that as soon as you plug it in, it should automatically switch, or you can touch the HDMI 1 button, which is right here, and that'll switch to your PC. Now, something I want you to notice here, depending on the screen size of your laptop, you might get a little bit of space on the sides just because it's matching your laptop screen. So most laptop screens are widescreen. It shouldn't look very funny, but my laptop is more square. So that's why you have a little bit of space on the side. Don't worry about it. The touch is still calibrated and the touch will still work. So you can see there that, you know, every time I touch it, it works just fine. Remember, if you don't have any touch after you plug it in, just check that USB cable to make sure it's all connected. The second thing that we need to check now that we have our laptop connected is the audio. So down in the bottom right corner of your laptop, you'll see that there's a speaker icon. And if I touch that, it shows the volume of the laptop. Now notice here that my laptop says IFP 7550. IFP is referring to the ViewBoard. All right, so what that's telling me is that if I play audio, it's going to play through the board speakers. So you can hear there the little ding. It's, you know, obviously you're on your laptop watching this, but the audio is coming through the speakers on the board. Sometimes when we first connect our laptops, it actually stays on the speakers that are on the laptop. So you'll see here it says Realtek High Definition. Yours might be different. The point is that it says speakers. Now the audio is actually coming through my laptop. It's coming behind me instead of the board itself. So one thing to check after you connect your laptop is to go to that speaker icon and then make sure it's not on speakers. Touch that section there and make sure it's on IFP. If it's on IFP, then you should get audio through the board speakers instead of your laptop. And the cool thing is that Windows will remember that. So the next time you connect your laptop, it'll just automatically switch to the speakers on the board. Also, don't forget, because we have essentially two computers controlling audio, if this audio is turned all the way up on my laptop, but the board speakers are turned down, by touching the volume buttons here, you'll see that there's a volume bar over here. If this is turned all the way down, but my laptop is turned up, I won't get any audio because the physical board speakers are not turned up. So to make sure you have maximum audio, turn up the sound on your laptop, but also make sure that the board speakers are turned up simply by touching the buttons, or you can grab this slider when it appears and you can drag the audio all the way over. So in review, make sure you have both cables, HDMI and USB. They may already be plugged into your board or they might be in that accessory box. Connect both cables into HDMI 1 and USB touch 1. Go ahead and test it out. Make sure your touch works. And also make sure that your audio setting is set to IFP, not built-in speakers.